Does red mean play? Are you serious? Is playing when it's on red?
Yiddy.
I was discriminated against being the valedictorian of my class because I'm black.
I dated a Chinese girl for 7 months. Yeah, she was hot.
I don't really hang out with a lot of white people because a lot of them's retarded.
I don't care what color you are, white, black, Puerto Rican, or anything.
My first reaction to her was like, she's white. My parents gonna freak out.
And when I got here, I learned that Charleston still has separate proms. And for me, that was a bit of a shock, because I always assumed that they had integrated proms together, like we did in Chicago.
Mississippi has got to get over the racism. The country redneck hicks stink here. And for far as I'm concerned, they can kiss my ass.
Boyfriend, or is it just somebody? He's my fiance. Thank you. I hope I get it, because I'm on the ballot. I hope I get king. I don't know who will get queen. I hope I get king.
Night. Can't believe I got two dates. That's gonna be pretty crazy.
That's the American dream anyway, to be better than the last generation. I don't know why they're afraid of change. I don't understand.
I'm offering them the opportunity to do it, to break this logjam of social inaction that persists, prevails among young people in this town, in this little bitty burg.
Tallahatchie waters slowing to a steel. Motions in a body, too afraid to live.
One of the things that surprised me most was the fact that they have separate proms, and they have separate homecoming queens. And one white, one black. How stupid can that be? And I said, why in the world do you have separate proms? Here you are all sitting here together. You go to school together. What's with the separate proms? They said, not our idea. We don't want separate proms. So, well, who does? School board? Parents? So you're not talking to the kids. You're not trying to change them. You're trying to change the people who teach them.
Everybody say, la, 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 la. I know you thinking that it must be armor off flow, cause it never get rusty. I ain't gotta say it, man, dog, trust me. Bust somebody head, TLC, where was we? Still rockin' Prada for that rock starter. Niggas had the Georgetown, the magic way harder. Thinking back to the projects and the way they tore them all up. Like when I do a project and come back and tell them all up.
Coming from the south, 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 side of the bronze. Cars, the half moon of the stars. I'm like Jeff Black, the way I get my bars. Burn CDs with no regards for the stars. Welcome to the
ground. One nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. And I also want to remind everyone that Mr. Paul Saltzman will be shooting in the schools today. So if you haven't signed your permission forms or you don't want to be filmed, please do your best to avoid the cameras.
I guess we just like Billy stuff.
I got black friends, white friends, a couple Mexican friends. I got everybody. I don't care about color. If they're nice to me, I'll be nice to them.
My friends, they're all black. I had one black friend a couple of years ago where I was real close to her. She lived right down the road from me.
I talked to like two or three white people in this school, and I'd never been over their house, and they'd never been over mine.
You know, we would talk and listen to music and stuff like that. I would go to her house. But I've never spent the night or anything like that.
I know quite a few people at the school that are racist, black and white. I believe they're racist because they think they're better than somebody else.
We've never gotten together and just, like, mingled as a whole.
Hopefully, is my prayer that we can use something as a catalyst to allow them to interact socially. The school gets away with it because they say, well, we don't sponsor it. And I'm trying to induce the kids, the parents, the school, to allow, you don't have to force it, you just have to allow these children to have social interaction, and they will. Some years ago, I was visiting the school and spoke to the senior class. I asked them about this whole thing of separate proms. And they said, well, we do have separate proms. And they couldn't explain clearly why. What do you mean? Is this what you want? They said, no, it's not what we want. Tradition is one thing. Idiocy is another. And to me, this is idiocy. So my idea, have us one prom. I'll pay for it. I think that might be an incentive for the whole town. And we'll just break this ice. What do you say?
Would this be the last initiative, or is this just something that, like you say, just breaks the ice?
Well, I think once it's done, you couldn't find a reason to undo it. I mean, there's no reason to think that children won't get along.
I think this is something that's going to greatly benefit our kids in the long run. I graduated from a Mississippi high school in 1977, and we had integrated proms way back then, so
we're concerned about safety.
Of course you are. Of course you are. But if we do have armed security, I think that should be in plain clothes.
Sure.
Okay.
So we would talk with our seniors, and we would talk with them about the first school-sponsored prom, and that you would fund everything.
All right. School's going to sponsor this prom. Morgan's going to pay for it.
We'll mention your name.
I'm excited already.
I left Charleston when I was 6 and a half years old. I was here from toddler until my paternal grandmother died. This was a paved street that I remember, if I remember correctly, and everything else was like dirt roads, particularly back off in this direction here. This was back over in here was black, and over here was white.
Racism has been here a while. I've seen pictures of a hanging on the square from a long time ago. I don't know what year it was. They had a noose in one of the trees on the square. Somebody I know, his grandparent had like the most slaves in Tallahatchie County or in Mississippi, and he lived here. A lot of the older people I know, they're pretty racist, you know, but they wasn't like the kind that would go hang anybody or anything. They just talk about it a lot. They talk about black people.
This feeling of racism only dates back because of what their ancestors did. they can't really think of a reason why they hate us, because if you take our color away, we're all the same.
They might think that it's payback time for what they did to us in the slavery days, but it's really nothing like that.
It's 2008. Why are you still going back to this same attitude that you had 50 years ago?
There's some hard-headed people in this town. I'm not just saying whites or blacks. I'm saying a little bit of both. This is a place of judgment. You're judged every day by every move you make, by the people you talk to. I mean, it's worse when it comes to skin color, of how bad you're judged. I don't like to be judged. I don't even like to be in the spotlight. And if I was to jump on a camera showing my face, it wouldn't do any good. Just have some people disliking me, maybe disowning me.
Play as hard as you can tonight. Do what you're supposed to. You're gonna win the football game. Let's have a prayer right here. Well, I just like to ask again for my season where I failed.
Have you with us this morning. We have a special guest, honored guest to be with us today. We're very privileged to have Academy Award winner, Mr. Morgan Freeman, and he has something to talk to you about, a proposal he has for the senior class. So at this time, would you make welcome Mr. Morgan Freeman.
Some years ago, I was here visiting school, and I talked to the senior class, and we were just talking about this, that, and the other. And they pointed out that they had separate proms, black prom and white prom. You're still doing that, right?
Yes, sir.
Uh-huh. Why?
Our parents.
It's the parents.
A little racism.
You think that's it? Is that your idea?
No, some people don't
like really. White people.
So I don't understand why, if it's not what you want, why you're doing it. Anybody got any ideas on that? I'll tell you what they told me. It was the school board and the parents. It seems silly to me. This is 2007, eight. So I have this proposal. Do you all want to have a prom instead of two or three? Who doesn't? Say, raise your hand. Who would like not like to do this? Don't be shy. So you're all in this together. You're all one on this idea. You all arrange your prom. I'll pay for it. Deal?
Yep.
Deal.
Any questions?
Mr. Freeman, are you gonna make an appearance at our prom?
No. When you have your prom, I'm gonna be working in New York. There was another hand went up back there, and then I got you. Yes, ma'am.
So, Mr. Freeman, why exactly are you doing this?
I live here. I think it is the stupidest thing I've ever heard of, that in this time, this period in our lives, you children are being brought up this way. I just
it hurts me deeply. And he said, well, where do you live? I live in Mississippi. Mississippi? Yeah, there's a problem there. Well, you know, yeah, so, and then I have to report, well, our kids, we live in a very small town and our kids go to separate proms. So, well, can you explain that? No, I don't want to explain that. But I do want to end it. And from what I'm hearing this morning, so do you. Am I right about that?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Excellent. You'll do it. I'll write the check. So any more questions?
What's our limit?
What's your limit?
Yeah, budget.
I don't want to set a limit.
Oh.
You said it.
Oh.
$200. Yes, darling.
Can I have a handshake?
Oh, what are you doing?
All right.
Be like me.
Okay. Thank you all very much.
We'll see what happens. I kind of know, but I mean, if it's left up to the kids, it's gonna be fine. If the grown-ups get too involved, if there are too many restrictions, they get the feeling that they're being watched, it's gonna be different.
My parents, they are racist, but I love them and I accept the fact that they're racist. I mean, I don't completely understand because I guess I'm the opposite. Maybe them being the way they are is the reason they don't know what I believe, you know? You shut the door on somebody when you completely shut them out, not considering their feelings at all or what makes them happy or what brings them joy in life. When you don't consider that, then you're shutting a certain door in a relationship with your parents and parents of their kids.
Soon after Morgan Freeman came to make his offer about funding the joint prom, there was an incident that occurred between a female white student and another female black student. The female white student made a statement as to, well, I don't want to attend the joint prom, just voicing her opinions. And so the female black student, of course, wants to defend herself, and they end up in a quarrel. And somehow the female white student says that she's being threatened by the black student.
This white girl said unto me that it was not right for us to have a prom together. And so I retaliated and I said so back, because it really doesn't make sense to have two proms. We could just have one prom because they go to school with us. So we just got the argument from there and word started coming from both of us.
And next thing I know, Principal Smith calls the students into their office and is more open to what the white female student has to say. And the female black student was baffled by what was told to her by the administrative staff.
Her mama called to the school, and then the school got involved, then the Board of Education got involved, and then the police got involved because she said, I brought a gun, and I was going to shoot her with it.
And so they ran with it, and it just got out of hand.
I don't even have a gun. I don't know the names of guns, so no, I did not bring a gun.
This whole quarrel was just the threats and so forth was just a blatant lie. I was there in the classroom and didn't hear any threats whatsoever from the black student. It was more or less the student just defending herself.
She was white and I'm black, and at this school, the white always win.
To me, it was more like a slap in the face because the white kids can say whatever it is that they would like, but the black kids are just supposed to keep their mouths shut and say nothing at all.
And she turned a lot of people into the office. I was actually one of the people she turned in and said that black people were gonna pay me to beat her up where it wouldn't be a black on white fight, it'd be a white on white fight.
Mm-hmm.
right together, feeling prom. Tossing, finally doing a bit, said I'm lagging, get up off my lawn. Let me say the other word, I'm gonna really say this great. You don't wanna really wanna see me, cause your boy be on this fucking mic, I'm ripping it. CHS.
Some people don't wanna go because they think that it's like not right. Cause some people believe in like white and black separate.
There's no lie, Morgan Freeman said it all. So you know this party's going on. And you know that we the ball. Group my nigga by my side.
We can call
my cousin Shaggy.
Are we gonna be able to enjoy their music? Will they enjoy our music? Will it be a big fight? Will it be a controversy over just us being together in one big room?
I think the prom being joined together is actually a great idea. We all grew up together from kindergarten to high school, so I don't understand why we should part at prom when it's our last prom, you know. We should have a good time.
Hey, don't cut that out.
We in trouble. Get the class. We in trouble. Get the class.
Y'all get back to class. Now.
Teacher, we should talk about those.
Y'all better get class.
And that's what's up.
What's up? Y'all causing too much disruptions. Y'all need to get to class. I'm playing something. Get into class. Thank you. Excuse me, Miss Tay.
I think Mr. Morgan's offer is really good. It's always been separate proms, and that's kind of awkward to still be going on, as he said, in 2007, 2008. So I think it's a good idea that he's trying to make a change here. I play all girls sports. I'm into softball, basketball, track, and I'm a state champion powerlifter. And outside of school, it's just church, and that's it. A white boy liked me when I was in ninth grade, and you know, we were into texting and all that. He started texting me, and we were real friendly and stuff, but we never dated. I don't think it would have worked anyway. I don't think his parents would have liked it because they were over the white prom, so I don't think that would have. I take college algebra advanced math with a white girl. Her name's Cecily Hardy.
Chastity skipped a grade. She's 16, 17. She's so bad wanting to be valedictorian. Now I know she's gonna be, you know. Every time I see her, I just wanna slap her for saying it. I'm so scared. I said, what are you scared for, you know?
She's really nice. I trust her with everything that we talk about concerning the prom and concerning other issues. I think she's very trustworthy. I trust her before I trust some of my black friends, only because I know the type of person that she is.
My mama, she was raised by a black woman. While her mama was at work, she had a black nanny, and she loved her to death, and I just learned to love people for who they are and not for the color of their skin.
I've always been a nice person. That's just the way that I am, no matter what color you are.
Hi, I'm Jessica again. I take care of my little sister. I pretty much have a full-time job. Since I leave school, I go to work. I work there, and then I do yard work. I do anything I can to make money, get the bills paid, take care of my mom. My stepdad's in prison. My father's passed away. And it's been pretty hard on me for the past couple of years.
Me and Jessica, we've been dating for 9 months now. And I love her to death. That's my sweetheart. And Calvin, I've been knowing him for probably about 2 years now. We've been ever since we first started hanging around with each other. We just clicked, you know. And, he's my best friend, one of my best friends, you know.
I started hanging out with Calvin, and my parents threatened me. My stepfather taught me not to be around a nigger, and if he caught me, he would beat me to death. And actually, one day he did. This is after I had moved out. He pulled up in my yard, asked me what in the hell was the black boy doing there. And I was like, that's my friend. He's welcome here. You're not. If you feel that uncomfortable, you can leave. He was like, if that's the last thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna kill him. I wasn't scared. It was my house, you know? And Calvin was more than welcome. I mean, when I wasn't hungry, my parents wouldn't feed me. Calvin was. Yeah. I mean, that's my friend. I mean, that's a true friend.
I don't look at someone because they're white or because they're black. I just look at people because what's inside of them, how they make me feel when I'm around them. But the adults around here, you don't tell them that because they'll get mad at you, real mad. There's people around here that'll disown their kids if they try to mix things up like that. I know a lot of parents, not just one or two, a lot of parents are like that.
Let's go ahead and get started. I want to introduce each member of the committee, the two administrators we have, myself, I'm the high school principal, Ms. Gwen Lewis, the high school assistant principal, Ms. Chastity Buckley, National Honor Society president, Andy Smith, National Honor Society vice president, Jordan Kelly, FBLA president, Jericho Chambers, FEA president and student council, Cecily Hardy, student council president. We want you to be comfortable with the rules, but at the same time, we are responsible for you, and this is new for us, so we may be a little tighter, a little stricter than maybe y'all would like, but at the same time, we want to make sure that you're safe. Kelsey.
Will you have someone there as far as security goes in case something goes wrong?
Mr. Johnson will be there, and of course, all the men, members of the staff, will be there to take care of any problems that come up.
I think overall, we don't want y'all to feel like you're being hovered over, but at the same time, we'll be watching. You know, well, we're going to watch out for your best interests, and we'll have people there that can handle situations like that.
Jordan?
People could bring in pills and put them in drinks or do anything right. Like that.
We will be taking precautions to make sure we're all doing like the things we need to be doing.
The way we behave and what we do with this prom is going to determine if other students in the future do it. We need to be responsible.
And if we're going to make this something positive for our school and our community, it's up to each of you. And when I'm saying that now, I'm looking straight at you students. You are the future of this area.
And if you're already negative and you know you're not coming to the prom, it'd be, I think, appropriate for you to go to Coach Smith at the end of the day and say, I want off the committee, I need to be replaced, and take that approach.
We had one white student that we had selected to be on the prom committee that, because of conflicts, decided that she didn't want to attend the prom or to be on the committee, so she removed herself. And I'm not sure still if that was her decision or parental decision. Doggone it.
She said that she wasn't going to the prom and she wasn't going to go. And that's how she felt about it, because she didn't like black people. I've tried talking to her and telling her, you know, God put us all here for a reason. You know, it's not for us to be racist, because, I mean, that's a ticket to hell, if you ask me.
She'd had a problem with everybody at one time about the prom. Now, all of a sudden, she just ain't got nothing to do with it no more.
She said somebody wants to shoot her or something.
Said they had a 48 in their purse.
Yeah. Who has a 48 in their purse?
I feel sorry for her, I really did, because the same way she's raised, the same way I was raised, but she's actually sticking with it. She's actually being racist.
This morning, y'all, I want you to vote on whether you are coming to the prom or you are not coming to the prom. I need your name on the sheet of paper. I need you to put yes or no whether you are coming to the prom. If you know who your date will be, I do need to know the name of the person that you will be bringing to the prom. Of course, if you write no, that's perfectly fine. That's all you will need to put on the piece of paper other than your name. I'm going to ask Jericho and LaQuanta to collect these from you. Please pass them to either one of those students.
So how was the prom when you were in high school?
It was black only. A lot of the white students, you know, would have went if it had been their choice. But, you know, it wasn't their choice. It was their parents' choice.
Jess, hurry up.
I want to see your dress.
I'm coming.
Oh, goodness, I love it.
What about the bag?
It looks good.
Are you sure?
Oh, it's so pretty.
It looks great.
You gonna be the spotlight.
Sure, why not? Not for prom, though.
She's self-conscious about the cleavage. Oh, my gosh. I mean, it's eye-catching, even the front end of that. Like something.
Am I stunning? Am I gonna knock them out?
You're gorgeous.
Yeah.
After Morgan made the offer to the senior class, we began to hear that there was some white parents that are still planning on having their own separate prom. They did not want their children to go to the prom with blacks. And it's kind of disheartening because the point is to get the kids together.
As far as I know, there's still going to be a white prom, and I don't really know what the date of it is, but it's pretty soon.
The students that are attending only the white prom, I think they need some sort of something to slap them in the face. Because when there's something out there for you, a chance for you to make a change, why not take it?
People doing the white prom, I mean, that's cool. They raise money for it and stuff.
They can go to hell for all I care. They stupid. Why would you want to have a prom separate?
I'm going to the integrated prom. That's it.
Holding the white prom isn't really a good idea because people are going to look at it like you're racist or whatever. But I mean, I'm going just to have a good time and to be with some of my friends who may not be at the other prom.
My parents want me to go to both proms because I don't know why, but they do. And for the white face prom, I'm just going to get like a cheap dress and not do nothing real spectacular. But I'm going to go out all out for the other prom.
Everybody I know that's going to the white prom, it's just because their parents won't let them go to the pre-prom.
My mom, she wouldn't be able to tell me what to do. I'm 18 now.
I know that's right.
Some of them still, I mean, they don't do what their mama tell them to do. Some stuff, like some of them drink, get drunk every weekend. Your mama tell you to get drunk?
Having two proms is pretty stupid, and I don't see what everybody's problem is. It's supposed to be equal.
When I was in high school, we had black friends and white friends, but I mean, when it came time for prom, it was just a given that they were gonna have their prom and we were gonna have our prom. I mean, that's just the way it had always been.
I'm excited about the prom.
I mean, if Chance had said, I wanna go to the white prom, we'd have went to the white prom. You know, it was totally up to Chance.
There's a meeting tonight and it's on the white prom. It's no black people are allowed at this prom. The white parents wanted us to go to the white prom this year, and I said they would pay for us for free to go and everything. And we went to a meeting, and it was me and Jessica. The woman's house that we were at, her daughter was being threatened, so-called being threatened, because she was racist. And she just was talking about in this and in that. And the way the parents used the word nigger and was being mean and just saying that their children couldn't be around them and didn't want them around them. They were talking about how niggers wasn't gonna grind up on my daughter and they wasn't gonna run up to them and dance up on them. That's just not happening. We're not gonna have mixed babies in my family. We decided to leave. My fiance got up and left first. the way they were just talking, I just, you know, we just walked out. Because, I mean, it was just ridiculous. Why act like that? I mean, they were a prom.
It niggers ain't going to be running, yeah, rubbing up on my daughter at no prom, and it, yeah, ain't happening in this house. As long as she's living with me, she will not attend a mixed prom. That's not how we raised her.
I guess you'd consider me a redneck. I've got camouflage on. I fit the profile, so I don't change for nobody. I'm Glenn. You either like me or you don't. I'd rather you like me. If you don't, just leave me alone. I'll do the same. I've got a daughter named Heather. She's 17, and she goes to Charleston High School. She's got a boyfriend named Jeremy. I think he's also 17. And she's white, and he's black.
You go first.
Well, we were in the at the end of seventh grade, and we just started talking. And then in eighth grade, we became really close friends, and we just talked on the phone every night, and then we just started going out.
I seem to think it different.
That's how it was.
I think it was at the end of seventh grade, but I was trying a long time before that, and you never gave me a chance.
Heather wants us to accept her and Jeremy. Personally, you know, I don't agree with it. And I hadn't whooped her. I've tried grounding her and taking her phone away, of course. But that didn't do any good. She overcame all that.
I didn't want to find somebody my own race because I really liked him.
She hollers I'm racist. You can ask anybody that knows me, which several hundred people around town know me because I've been here for years and years, that I'm not racist. I'll help anybody any way I can. But like I say, it's just gonna be so hard on her when she gets older. She got blinders on, so all she can see is straight ahead. She can't see from side to side because she hadn't got no experience in life. She's still a child.
In the morning times, I get up and I take a bath and get dressed and I text Jeremy.
I kind of have an alarm clock for when the bus comes, and I text Heather for a little while till I get to school.
She's never went out on a date with him, and that's my choice. That's not hers, because I still have a little control because I'm the parent right now. She's fixing to be 18 and going to college. I'm not going to have no control over that as long as she's out. But when she's at home, I've got a little say-so over what she does.
Now, we've avoided talking about the sexual aspects of this separation, but that separation is primarily black boys and white girls. It's like this bugaboo of sex is just absolutely drowned out common sense in terms of how young people interact.
It might be it. It might be the fear of your white daughter conceiving with a black man. That might be the fear. You're afraid of presenting, coming out, you're white and you have a mixed baby.
I've had white lovers as well as black lovers. I mean, there's really no difference. It's all what's inside you, how you feel about that person. That's what the world needs to see. I mean, right? It's not all about skin color. It's not all about what people think about you. It's about how you feel. You're gonna do what makes you happy. I'll do what makes me happy. People who try and stop that are the people who are gonna be sadly disappointed in the long run.
Library. All committee members are asked to attend. Thank you.
I mean, I'm cool with a lot of the white girl and everything, but I never dated one.
Why not?
I don't know. I don't know.
I've only dated white boys because I've always been brought up to date in my race. I guess I think that if I did it, I would be disappointing my family or disowned or something like that.
I've only dated white girls. I hadn't dated any black girls. I've thought about it. I didn't want to, though. I don't know. I just never get to know them, really.
I never just dated a white person.
And why not?
I don't know. I just didn't date one.
Well, my dating is mostly, all white, because I'm really not into the black people.
We're all excited about her first prom. This is not her senior prom, but this is history. You know, this is her chance to take her place and, you know, and make history. This is, you know, this is awesome. Other than your wedding, this is what all our girls dream about.
I mean, a few kids from our town is changing a little part of the world right now.
Well, I don't believe nothing's wrong with blacks and whites. We was always taught, you know, you stay with your own race, like, you know, don't try to mix and all that.
My grandmother always told us that we were all put on this earth different, and when we all start integrating, there's not going to be any more individuality, and we're all going to be the same, and if that's the way God wanted us, he would have made us all the same to start with.
My parents taught me about racism. If you're white, God wanted you white to be with white. And if you're black, God wanted you black to be with black. And you can't try and change them. Not somebody that's much older than you, not a whole nother generation. You can't change them. They've done lived their life, but they try to tell you how to live yours. And that's where the conflict comes in.
We can't keep muddling along in the most backward parts of your psyche, you know. You've got to break free of this. These are shackles. These are still chains we have around our souls.
We were sitting at an old store up the highway, and a sheriff pulled up. Two sheriffs pulled up. It was in one cop car. It was two of them, and they said they smelled marijuana on us. I don't know why, but anyway, they made all me and him get out of the car. Neither one of the cops searched me at all. Made him drop his pants on right beside the highway. Him drop his pants.
And like to right now, these the same cops that did it, they'll speak to me and, how you doing? And no, don't speak to me. You just violated me like that in public, you know, like out on the highway, just people riding by.
Just because we're black and white friends.
Yeah.
That's exactly. Ridiculous.
I can't get a job in some places in town because the racism's so bad here, because I have black friends and I get judged on it every day.
How does that make you feel?
It hurts my feelings, it really does, because you shouldn't judge somebody by their friends. That'll make me cry.
I'm gonna make some judgment on you because you got straight hair and blue eyes. For God's sake, you know, I'm doomed. You're fine. But I am doomed.
How do you mean that?
I mean, what can life hold for me? There's just too many of you. I can't be happy. You're all around me.
Do you know that guy actually pulled me over? I was going 27 and a 25.
How we know that? You lied a while ago.
Mando!
Man, what happened to your eye? What happened to your eye?
Nick was going to Jackson to pick up Marlon, right? He grabbed the steering wheel
Steering wheel.
Yeah, while I was driving.
Steering wheel.
Yeah. And he reached over, and I couldn't see nothing, so I pinched my arm.
Me?
I pinched his arm. And he swung playing, but he actually hit me.
But you were going
on the interstate?
No. I'm serious. Watch this.
Oh, you got a video.
No, I'm finna call my brother. Marlon. Didn't you hit me in my eye to make it black? Didn't you hit me in my eye to make it black?
No.
Wow, that looked nice.
You sharp, ain't it, Ava?
Kitty girl. Ooh, now that blue's pretty. Okay, now. Squishy side goes down.
You're gonna have to hit.
So I get a boost. Now,
the other thing that
I'm going to prom with my boyfriend, Derek Thomas. He is nice, sweet, kind of quiet, not too quiet, but yeah. Get it.
I don't think I know who I'm going to the prom with. Y'all taping all these, Elaine? Y'all gonna cut all it out of the way?
I don't know who I'll go with, white, black, some, I don't know. I don't know yet, it hadn't hit me.
I have a girlfriend now, and she's a freshman. But I don't really know. I might just go by myself, just to be on the safe side.
It's pretty. I like it.
I like it, too.
Yeah, it needs to be taken up around the bus.
Me and Colton, who is my boyfriend, are going to prom together this year. He loves me, and he's really nice. He's a gentleman.
Excited about prom?
Yes, ma'am.
Good. Okay.
I love my job. It's a lot of stress, a lot of long hours. I don't like being an administrator from the standpoint of the relationships you have with your students and your kids. You know, I miss coaching from that standpoint. 4 years ago, I was diagnosed with an aortic aneurysm, and I had my heart taken plumb out of my body and patched a defective aorta. And I couldn't wait to get well so I could get back home, so I could get back to school, so.
Good morning, ladies.
I think we have decided on that date. I just want to make sure it's still okay with everyone here.
April the 19th is the only time there's not baseball, softball, powerlifting, or track going on.
Okay, so I think that's decided. I want to move on down to number 5 on the theme. And the ladies and several of our students have already been working on this.
2 minutes starting blue.
Too much black.
Yeah, it's kind of sad. And then it's got just orange.
What I want y'all to do today is to come up with 3 or 4 choices. And then y'all can carry these back to you. Let the senior class vote on them.
And I know, fellas, there are some pinks in here, but I didn't mean for it to be pinks.
It should be something about, like, something to remember, a night to remember.
Now I have the Golden Age and Prom 2000 for the options. Drifting on a memory for the theme, and I heard somebody say a night to, that was my prom, a night to remember. That was only 5 years ago.
Well, I'm going to both proms, the white prom and the joint prom. We finally get to have, you know, a real good time together. I think we're gonna have a blast. I play basketball. I'm the only white guy on the team.
Yeah! Thank you! How you doing?
I love it, actually. Most of all my friends are on the basketball team. My coach gave me the nickname White Chocolate. I have no idea why. White Prom is going to be this Friday. It's going to be in Batesville at the Armory.
I bet maybe 35 people there.
I kept getting calls, you know, about his chance coming to the White Prom and about the prom meetings.
Jordan and Kelsey had texted and wanted to know if I was still coming, and they texted me for maybe two or three weeks straight, and I finally looked at them and I was like, no, I'm not coming.
I said, you know, Chance is not coming. He's going to the mixed prom.
They were like, well, we need more white people. We need a bunch, you know, all the seniors to be there for the senior walk and a prom king and prom queen. And that stuff like that doesn't matter to me.
The parents that I've spoken to that are organizing the white prom just really don't want the film crew anywhere around it.
If the film crew came onto the property or whatever at the Armory and Batesville, then I heard rumors about them getting prosecuted, arrested, and all this crap.
Really, what it's about is having a party for all the kids who happen to be white, and it's really just a little prom for them.
On the way to the white prom, it was so crazy. We were in this big, white Cadillac Escalade. Everybody was getting wild in the limo, drinking and stuff. Everybody's getting a little tipsy. Everybody's getting crazy. Paul asked me if I could do a little interview before I walked in. You know, I was totally cool with it. So I asked the limo driver before we get there to notice them on the side of the road, like a few blocks away, and so they could stop, you know, let me and my date off and do the interview. I'm not gonna say any names, but a lot of people in the limo were like, no, keep going, don't stop for them. Just saying some more things, you know.
That is a limo.
It was ridiculous that the limo driver wouldn't stop.
You excited about tonight's prom?
Yes, ma'am.
Ah, that's great. Are you excited about tonight's prom?
I'm really excited.
Yeah? What's it gonna be like?
I'm not real sure. I'm hoping it's gonna be real fun. I'm not really sure what they're having in there.
The reason everybody's making such a big deal about it or whatever is because everybody's, you know, giving attention to it. If everybody just like let it die down, then it wouldn't be as big of a deal as everybody's making it out to be.
I think it may be the last one, I think.
There was like a big staircase, and there was like a big walkway with chairs on each side, kind of like a church almost. It was a buffet-style catered dinner. You had to serve yourself, and the food was like ham sandwiches, pizza, chips, dip. There wasn't much dancing at all, being as there was only white people there. Two guys got in a fight over a girl, and Jordan's mom went ballistic, pushed one guy aside and slapped the other one, and told him to get out of there. When they first called me to be prom king, I was shocked. I didn't expect to be picked. I didn't know people liked me. I was happy to win. Not every day you get picked to be prom king. But I didn't really tell any of my black friends that I was a king or whatever. Cause I think they'll probably just laugh. Everybody was asking me if I had a camera, hidden camera on me. I was like, yeah, say hey. And then they were telling me that I was gonna get taken to jail. I mean, I was really thinking about not going in the first place after I heard all that.
Smile for the camera.
Smile for the camera, that's all right.
I have spoken to my clients and they do not wish to speak to you at this time for fear of being categorized as racist or bigots or hypocrites.
The white parents who put on the white prom won't talk to you because, I mean, they're racist, really what it comes down to, and the racist people, they don't want the whole world to know they're racist because maybe a small portion of them knows it's not right to be racist, and they're not going to change the way they are, but they're not going to let the whole world know how they are.
Barack Obama's is running for president, and I'm totally on his side of this. He said, we're not a bunch of separate people in terms of our nationalities. Who we are is one people. We're either gonna be Americans or not. Can't be reds, blues, blacks, and whites. We just cannot survive that way.
When we first got together, my friends were not really accepting of it, and they didn't like it, but I really didn't care. I lost a lot of friends, but it didn't matter to me.
You gonna slap who?
What is it?
What's wrong with you?
What's it?
There's not many interracial couples in Charleston. We're like one of the very few. And that's why we try not to have it out in public. We don't usually hold hands. Like at break, we're usually sitting in our locker together, but not holding hands.
I'm really excited about being able to go to the prom with Jimmy, and I think it's really cool that we can go together. And
just the experience of being like a black and a white person at a prom, you know, then it's an interracial prom. It'd be exciting. It'd be different.
See, I don't even plan to go to her senior walk myself. Because it's not because I don't love her. It's because I don't agree with what she's doing. Now, I'm all for mixed prom. You know, you bring your partner, he bring his. You go to school together every day.
My parents taught me about the white people. They told me to really just not associate with them, to be honest, because all the dangers of me, you know, like back in the past, we got hung if we really just said anything to them. And over the years, they, you know, realized that I was with her, and there's nothing they really could do about it, but they told me to be very careful.
Heather folks ain't gonna too quick let Heather come over here. And I wouldn't too fast let Jeremy go over to Heather's. I mean, where it could be some of Heather and them neighbors see Jeremy leaving there a certain time of night and run Jeremy off the road.
The blacks have always taught the blacks to, you know, hate whites, and the whites have always taught their kids to, you know, to hate blacks. My daddy did it, my granddad did it, so I'm gonna learn to do it. And if you got hatred at home, you're gonna learn to be a hater too. And until, you know, the parents break the cycle to the children are gonna pass it on to their children.
My love for him is really, really deep. I don't know. It's really indescribable. It's just really good.
My love for her, I really can't put it into words, you know. I just try to act it out every day because it's not really an act. I, you know, feel it every day, every time I see her, you know.
I hope when they graduate, which is another month or so, that he goes to Mississippi State or wherever he's gonna go, and she goes over here and starts her nursing program. I hope that they grow farther. I'm being selfish now. This is just how I feel. I hope to grow further and further apart and go their own separate ways.
What's going on, Paul?
Nothing much, John Ellis. How about you?
Oh, nothing much. Just trying to figure out some stuff. It's going to sound crazy, but looks like I have two dates for prom at the moment. Oh, gosh. Let me just explain. Well, I asked Omega Manuel to the prom, right? She said, yeah. And all of a sudden, she texts me and says she's so sorry she can't come. Her grandmother's passed away, which is okay. She's not going to be able to go to the prom. So I'm like, okay, that's fine, you know. I'm sure I can find another date. So I ask Emily, and she's like, yeah, I would love to go. You know, she didn't have a date. Well, her date dropped out on her, so that would have worked out perfect. Well, after Emily had already gone all the way to Memphis this morning and bought herself a dress to match my tux or whatever, 2 or 3 minutes ago, Omega texted me and says, guess what, I can go. What do I do? You know, Emily's already bought her dress, and you know, I feel real bad if I told her, you know, never mind. So, I wonder if they'll mind if all three of us go together. I mean, that'd be pretty awesome to me, 2 dates, you wouldn't see that much. Now, that'd be awesome. I'm gonna text Emily and see what her deal is.
It's the morning of the prom. I'm very excited. I'm praying that the prom will be very, 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 very successful and we won't have any problems in it.
I think we might have a little problem. I don't think we might have any in the inside, but probably on the outside. But we're going to get with the Grenada Police Department, which is the place that we're going to hold the prom. And they're going to work with us on keeping the outside safe, but we'll have the proper security there to take care of all of that.
Cufflinks, man.
Where's Pink John? Is it tight enough?
Yes.
Tight enough. I guess that's how it goes.
Since you're sleepy, honey, I'm gonna put a little cucumber shade on your eyes. Since you can dance the night away tonight.
I was discriminated against being the valedictorian of my class.
They're supposed to go with who has the highest average GPA or whatever, but I have the highest grades and I went in number one and they're saying I'm number two now. But they don't have any proof. They won't show her average or her GPA, but they're saying that mine's lower and she's beating me.
It's sad, but it's true, you know?
There's some things going on now about a white girl getting valedictorian and when it should be a black girl do it, they all kind of rumors going around.
It's gotten her down, and a lot of teachers have noticed that it's gotten her down. And now she has this attitude like, you know, no matter how I try, you know, they're gonna find a way to take it from me.
If you have the grades, if you have what it takes, whether you're black or white or you're male or female, you should be given what you earned, what you worked so hard for.
Don't just always think that, you know, we got to settle for second or third, and then that'll get in their heads and think, no matter how I try, they're gonna find a way to take it from me.
Unfortunately, this year, there is a controversy. However, in the last 8 years, 4 of our valedictorians has been black. In this case, the young lady that won valedictorian was ahead on points.
Anyway, tonight's my night, and I'm just gonna have fun and not worry about anything else.
Come on, get you some free.
I promise.
Ladies and gentlemen, before exiting the train, please leave your valuables, diamonds, rubies, and pearls in the cabinet that Jason Taylor left. The pussycats and the jackals, you can leave them with me.
Tell her a good time tonight. I'd like to thank George Washington. Come on.
Please, just, I'm not.
Give me a kiss. I'm
sorry.
Give me a kiss. You better give me a kiss.
Now.
I'm really nervous.
The one thing that's going through my mind right now is the fact that I hope no one just shows out because, you know, white people is showing up. You know, I hope we all just get along like the old saying.
I'm nervous because the prom's tonight. I don't know.
Please. Been a lot of work went into making this event happen. Would everyone give the seniors a round of applause?
evening. Would you bow your heads for prayer, please? Thank you, God, for allowing everyone to be a part of a great opportunity. God, allow this not to be the ending, but the beginning of something wonderful. We thank God for every person who has come out to support our seniors. We thank you, God, for the food we are about to receive. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Mr. Freeman is busy tonight working, could not make it, but he did want to send a little something to you, the seniors.
Hi, kids. Well, comes the day. Believe it or not, it's a historical occasion. You will look back on this day later on in your lives, I hope. I certainly will. And I hope when you look back, you will look back with pride and joy. And I hope that you really do enjoy yourselves. Congratulations.
That's Barrett. He's cute, ain't he? What's my other friend?
Seniors, please line up for the senior wall.
Right here. This is Chan. This is my other friend. He's yeah. cute, too.
I know. Perfect.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. This is John. He's my other friend. He's cute, too.
Senior Chastity Buckley. Chastity is escorted tonight by Willie Bradford. Senior Cecily Hardy. Cecily is escorted by senior Colton Brownlee.
Oh my God, we have white people too in the front. We have black, gonna party together. It's gonna be off the chain. We're gonna have so much fun. Oh my God, oh my God.
Senior Emily Goodwin is being escorted tonight by Senior John Ellis Gray. Senior Jericho Chambers. Tonight, Jericho is escorting Shaniqua Cosby. Senior Omega Manuel. Omega is escorted tonight by Senior John Ellis Ray. I think that was twice, John Ellis Ray. Senior Tammy Oriola. Tammy is escorted by Senior Derek Thomas. Senior Kimberly Prince is being escorted tonight by Senior Aaron Johnson. Senior Lacey McCord. Lacey is escorted by Senior Chance Ribby. Senior Jessica Shivers. Jessica is escorted tonight by TJ Logan. Senior Heather Sumner. Heather is being escorted tonight by Senior Jeremy Reed. Let's give the seniors of 2008 a big round of applause.
Thank you.
is Erin Johnson. Our prom queen this year is Francesca House.
Are we gonna go ahead and get all you guys to have a dance?
Come back and take over Charleston High School. Make it better. Take over the whole school district. They may change in the next couple of years. Maybe not. If not, I plan to make a change. I plan to make a difference.
One hop this time. One hop this time. Six hops this time. Right foot, two stumps. Left foot, two stumps. Slide to the left. Slide to the right. To the left. Check it out, y'all. How low can you go? Can you go down low? All the way to the floor? Can you bring it to the top? One hop.
I'm planning on running for mayor of Oakland in 2009. Get married and have a family that I can live the rest of my life with and pass things on that I've done to my kids and my nieces and nephews.
This is the Memphis Bench. Big round of applause, please.
School, and then probably I'll probably come back to Charleston. I get a girl, get married.
Somebody. We're coming out of Charleston, Mississippi, and I hope y'all see me on the big screen one day because I'm coming.
How serious what y'all doing tonight is, all right? Y'all making history. So to all them people that's scared of what's going on in this room tonight, this next song is gonna be dedicated to them. This is for all the people. When they come up to you and they say something to you tonight about y'all being in this prom, the white folks and the black folks having a good time, you tell them you just scared. Put your arms up in the air one time. Everybody, put your arms up.
Who's scared? Who's scared? Who's scared? Who's scared? Who's scared?
because I hope I can stay in touch with all my classmates, but they keep telling us, you know, that's going to be the last time we're all together as a group, and it strikes a blow into your stomach.
Actually, we enjoyed carried on further, like after college. Hopefully get married.
I know. I would really like to get married to Jamie and eventually have kids since he don't want any right now, so.
No.
You can't determine who your child's gonna love and not love, but I'm gonna stick with her. No matter what decision she makes, because I love her that much, I'm not going to turn my back on her ever.
New generation coming up now, it's going to really change Charleston. It is. There's going to be people mixing relationships, blacks and whites talking, dating, being friends. It's going to be one community eventually. And if not, it's going to be a lonely community. Because this new generation, they're going to do what they want to do to be happy. This might make people mad, but they'll be happy, won't they?
My prayer that we can use something as a catalyst to allow them to interact socially. We'll see what happens.
God bless y'all. Y'all have a good night.
Group photo.
Let's thank Morgan.
1, 2, 3.
Thank you, Morgan. Thank you, Morgan. Woo!
More of the white people. They're actually kind of talking to us more, even though we're seniors and been together forever. I think they're actually talking to us more since prom.
digging up all our skeletons. We never get too far until we accept forgiveness. So many letters and so many words, so many hearts are bruised by the words that we have taught our children to live by. We call people by the color of their skin, and we're damaging life where the negativity stands. No bright colors, no happiness implied. Cause we've all fought for freedom in some way, some land, somewhere. With God holding our hand, holding our hand, holding our hand. Won't you just stay? Mississippi.